Well, at-home DNA tests are incredibly popular. We've heard plenty of stories about people using them to connect with family members. But what about the medical side, those genetic tests that tell you if you're predisposed to certain diseases and disorders? Keep in mind, when you send away that cheek swab or saliva, you are sending away your full genetic code, the one that makes you uniquely you. So just how accurate are these tests, and what do they actually tell us? Here's Rena Sargentopoulos.
Steve Van Dinter grew up knowing he was Dutch.
In fact, we had the wooden shoes, we would take pictures, like, you know, we had little Dutch boy and girl in our yard.
Until one day, he suddenly wasn't.
It was intriguing for me to find out that our Dutch side is a very small percentage of who we are.
Steve did the 23andMe DNA test, which, by the way, has not gone over well with his adamantly Dutch parents. But there's more to the story. Steve didn't just test his ancestry. He consented to all the medical genetics testing, too.
I opted in for the Alzheimer's, I opted in for Parkinson's, I opted in for macular degeneration.
You'll get results back that will tell you everything from if you're able to smell asparagus in your urine, I'm not kidding, to whether you sneeze in the sun.
The genetic test said I was less likely to have photic reflex. My friends would all tell you, and my parents, I very much have it. It's something that happens to me every time I walk out in the sun.
But that, he says, is the only thing he felt was off about the results.
My grandma just recently was diagnosed with macular degeneration, and no surprise then to me that it came back that I carry the genes for possibly developing that.
No surprise is right, according to certified genetics counselor Sherry Baldinger.
You want to know the least expensive and sometimes most potent genetic test is a good family history.
In other words, Sherry could have told Steve without a test that he was probably at a higher risk for macular degeneration because of his grandmother's diagnosis. But not everyone has access to family history. So are these at-home tests accurate and worth your money? We went to not one,
buyer beware,
but two genetic counselors for their take.
Proceed with caution.
Shelley from Health Partners and Sherry from Allina both have the same concerns. First, accuracy. The testing companies are not all equal. Make sure the one you choose is using a CLIA certified lab, meaning the Food and Drug Administration, Center for Disease Control, and the Center for Medicaid Services have all approved. Two, while it may seem like you're getting a lot of information, even the best at-home tests are limited.
We look at your family history, we look at your lifestyle, we look at environmental factors. So all of those puzzle pieces really help me assess what is your risk for having a genetic disease.
Three, pay attention to what you're not getting. For instance, 23andMe was just FDA approved to test for mutations in the BRCA1 and BRCA2 genes, those associated with higher risk of breast and ovarian cancers.
The test that was offered is looking at three mutations out of thousands. And they're only common in the Ashkenazi Jewish population. It doesn't test for any of the other mutations in those two genes, nor does it test for mutations in other genes that create a risk for those cancers. So if I got the test and it was normal, it really hasn't told me anything.
It might lead you to believe that you're not at risk.
Exactly.
We reached out to 23andMe. While they wouldn't go on camera, they did issue a statement saying their standard for accuracy is unmatched in the market and that they were the only consumer company to get an FDA authorization. And if you scroll down to the small print at the bottom of their website, they state very clearly the limitations of their testing and that it should not be used to make medical decisions. Oh, and don't forget about this.
Maybe you want to know, how are they going to use your DNA? Do they save that sample? Sometimes they sell it to another company that's doing research.
Steve Van Dinter knew all the caveats before he sent off his saliva and says he still wouldn't change his mind.
I feel like if you're armed with information and there's a potential for you to do something to change that outcome, like, I want to know.
Just a couple other quick things. If you do decide to do this and you get a positive result back, it does not mean that you're necessarily going to develop one of these diseases in the future. Mm-hmm. Same thing, if you get a negative test back, it doesn't mean you're in the clear. Mm-hmm. Also, insurance. Right now, these genetic tests cannot affect your health insurance, but they can affect life insurance, long-term disability, anything like that. So they can ask you about those sorts of things when you apply for those types of insurances, disability insurance, for instance. and read the fine print. I was reading the fine print on what kind of information they collect on you. It's not even just your DNA, your digital footprint, all the things that they're collecting about you that you wouldn't even think about. Mm-hmm. We always just click, I agree. This is one of those situations where you really want to pay attention.
Want to think about it. I think it's such a good point, though. If it says you're not at risk for Alzheimer's, I think a lot of people that puts their mind at ease, and you don't really know if that's true or not.
You don't. So. There's so many other things that go into it, family history being one of them. So, and they're not; those tests are not taking that into account.
Great information.
Yeah. Thanks, Rena.
Thanks, Rena. Mm-hmm.